Hello everyone, my name is Christian Wimmer. I work for the Ludwig Maximilian Universität in Munich, and in this video I will show you how to configure password resources in EasyProxy. You usually have to deal with password resources when an IP check is not available. This happens mostly with smaller vendors and channels. The problem you are facing is that you somehow have to share the username and password with your patrons. EasyProxy can do an automatic login in the background, so you don't longer have to share the credentials with your users. And as always, some resources are harder to configure than others. In this presentation, I will show you two methods on how to configure EasyProxy for password resources. The most common method is the form variable method, and in case this fails, we can use the find and replace method, which is more complex. First, we are going to look at the form variable method, which is the most common method. Login is handled by EasyProxy in the background. Basically, you have to read the HTML source code of the login page and find the action URL, the form method, which is post or get, username and password field, and if required, some hidden fields. And with that information, you can build the stanza in EasyProxy. Now I will show you a demonstration of the form variable method. As an example, I've chosen the Bund Verlag with a journal called Soziale Sicherheit. This is the homepage of the journal Soziale Sicherheit from the Bund Verlag. First, let's find where we have to log in. This case is relatively simple. The login form is right over here. Sometimes I have links that say subscribers log in here or please log in here or something like that. It's a link you have to follow. Okay, yeah, I usually use Google Chrome to build my stanzas, and Google Chrome in this case has a very nice feature. I can just click into the form and say right click, inspect, and Google Chrome just does a pop-up and jumps right into the corresponding source code. The form starts here, form action something something, and goes until here. And this is the source code I have to look on and find the information I need to build the stanza. First of all, I have to find the URL. In this case, it's just a symbol. That means I can copy the homepage where I'm currently at. So this is the URL. Just make a note of that. URL is this. Then I have to find the method. It says that here, method post. I can just make a note of that. Method is post, which is the most common one. Then I have to find the form variables or fields where I have to input data. Usually that consists of a username and a password. Benutzername is username and password is password. Right click, inspect, it jumps right to the source code. I have to look at the name tag and it says username. So username field is called username. Make a note of that. Next, password. Again, right click, inspect, look at the name tag, password. So make a note of that. Password. That's usually a lot of the times that's just information you need. You need a username and a password. In this case, we also have a hidden field called action with the value login. It's usually just try and error to see if you actually need those fields. In this case, I know I need them. So make a note, we have a form variable called action with the value login. And with this information, I can now go ahead and build my stanza. With the information gathered from looking at the source code, we can now build the stanza. We start with a title. Title, Bund Verlag Soziale Sicherheit. Next is the URL line. In this case, we're using form post. This here tells EasyProxy to an automatic login. I've chosen Soziale Sicherheit to be the automatic login URL. And we're calling this URL here for the automatic login. Down here, for the form variables, are the name of the form variables we've identified, username, password, action, with the stuff we've have to enter. Username, password, in this case, login. And once you put everything together, the automatic login happens with this URL here. And this is how the user experience looks like. We link all our journals in the electronic journals library. Clicking the full text link, I have to log in. I see this page, and this is where EasyProxy does the automatic logging in the background. And now I have been automatically logged in and have access to the journal. The find and replace method can be used if everything else fails. It is more complex, more fragile, and usually requires quite a bit of trial and error. Find and replace is used to, well, find and place text in the source code. It can be used to prefill username and password fields. It can simulate a click on a login button via some JavaScript. You can even go as far as construct login buttons, if required, and it will reload the page on the first visit. Now I will show you the find and replace method on the new Journal of European Criminal Law. The find and replace method is required in this case because there is no real HTML form and the login button uses some JavaScript. This is the website of the new Journal of European Criminal Law. First of all, we have to find where we have to log in. It's relatively simple, it's right on the start page, right over here. Right click into the field, say inspect, and it jumps right into the source code. Please note that there's no form tag around here. It's a table instead. Also, if we take a closer look at the login button, you can see there's JavaScript on here. JavaScript, web form, blah, blah, blah. That's how we know that we have to use the find and replace method, because the form variable method simply doesn't work in this case. So we have to find the source code for the username. Right click, inspect. Okay, this is the source code for the username. Copy, paste. Then we have to find the source code for the password. Again, right click, inspect. This is the source code for the password. Just copy paste. And we have to find a place where we can do the automatic login. So basically some JavaScript code that does the clicks the button. I like to put the source code right up behind the source code of the login button, so I just say inspect and copy the whole thing. We also need the URL of the site, so copy that as well. So we have copied a lot of source code. Let's take a look at it. We have the URL. We have the source code for the username. We have the source code for the password field. And we have the source code for the login button. First, we need to identify the ID of the login button, because with the JavaScript, we are clicking the button and we need to identify which button to click. And that happens via the ID field, and the ID is back here. So the ID in this case is login view, login mini square, login button. The source code to click the button is always the same, so just copy it from somewhere. Get the ID. Copy that and enter it here. Make sure that you're not overwriting the single quotes here, because those are required. Then we can optimize the fields a bit, because, well, this is a lot of source code, hard to handle. We don't need all of it. We just need a unique part. So in this case, this should do, because this ID probably won't be on the page, or will be unique in the page. We can also shorten the username and password fields a bit, just to make it easier to handle. So in this case, I'm just going to remove the class field lock. So with this source code, we can now go ahead and build the stanza. And this is the source code that I came up with. We have a title line, we have the URL, domain. Pretty typical. The auto login happens down here. So first, find source code of the username field, replace with source code of the username field, but with an added value. And this is the value the vendor has given to you. In this case, value, my username, just a placeholder in this case. Find source code for the password field, replace it with source code of the password field and the password. And down here is the clicking of the button. So find the button, replace it with the start of the login button, but here we are adding the source code that does the automatic clicking. So this little JavaScript here is responsible for, well, the auto login. It finds the login button via the ID and clicks it. And this is how the user experience looks like. I select a full text link. I have to log in. The site loads and reloads right away. I'm now logged in and have access to the content. One of the downsides of this method is that I can't log out anymore. I click logout and get logged in right away. Just something to keep in mind. Additional information can be found in the EasyProxy reference manual. There's also an excellent article by Paul Steintorp on how to create EasyProxy stanzas for passworded resources. Thank you for your attention. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the EasyProxy Community Center or the EasyProxy mailing list.